prime factorization to find the greatest common factor and least common multiple of 840 and 765. So we're first going to find the factors of 840. 4 goes into 840 210 times, and then 4 can be broken down into 2 times 2. 3 can go into 210 70 times, and 70 can be broken down into 7 times 10, and then 10 is broken down into 5 times 2. And we know that these numbers cannot be broken down any further because they are all prime numbers. And so the prime factorization of 840 is 2 to the third, because we have 3 2s, times 3, times 5, and times 7. And so then we're going to go to 765 and find the factors of that. 5 goes into 765 153 times. And then 3 goes into 153 51 times. And then 3 can go into 51 17 times. And just like with 840, we know that these numbers cannot be broken down anymore because they're prime numbers. And so the prime factorization of 765 is 3 squared, because there are 2 3s, times 5, times 17. Now we're going to find the greatest common factor between 840 and 765. The greatest common factor is the largest factor that will go into both 840 and 765. So, to find the greatest common factor, we look and find the smallest numbers that are in common between the two. And so, there is no 2 in common between these factorizations. There is a 3, but 3 is smaller than 3 squared, so we're going to use 3. There is a 5 in both. But there is not a 7 or a 17 in both. So your greatest common factor is 3 times 5, which is 15. Now we're going to find the least common multiple. And the least common multiple is the smallest number that both 840 and 765 will go into. So to figure that out, we use all of our numbers, but we use the greatest number out of the numbers. So we have a 2 to the third. And then we see our 3s. There's a 3 in common, but 3 squared is greater than 3, so we're going to use 3 squared. And there's a 5 in common in both of them. We have a 7 and a 17. And so this equals 8 times 9 times 5 times 7 times 17. Which equals 42,840. So our greatest common factor is 15, and our least common multiple is 42,840. And to check this, we're going to use a method called the slide method. And first, you'll just set it up like this to write 840 and 765 beside each other. So first, we're going to find what factor can go into 840 and 765. And we can see that a 5 can go into both of these. So 5 goes into 840. Five goes into 34 6 times. And 5 goes into 48 times. So 5 goes into 840 168 times. And then 5 goes into 765. 5 goes into 7 once. 5 goes into 26 5 times. And 5 goes into 15. 3 times. So 5 goes into 765 153 times. And so then you're going to see what number goes into both 168 and 153. And that is going to be a 3. And so 3 goes into 168 56 times, and 3 goes into 153 51 times. And so there is no other number that will go into both 56 or 51, so we know that we're done. And the numbers over here are your greatest common factor. So the greatest common factor is 5 times 3, which is 15. And then your least common multiple is all of these numbers. So it's 5 and 3, and then 56 and 51. So it's the far left column and the bottom row, those numbers. So 5 times 3 times 56 times 51, which equals 42,840. And we see that the greatest common factors match on both the factor tree and the slide method, and 42,840 is the least common multiple on both. So we know it correct.